What's the problem? Good night.
It's no problem. We're just waiting until 3 o'clock.
I got 258.
He said, "Where are you going to get water?"
No, but it's after 3 o'clock.
What time is 3 o'clock?
The most merciful, the truthful, the most just. I greet everyone in our nation's greetings of peace. May Allah's salam alaikum. May Allah's peace be upon you. It is a pleasure to welcome all of you, whether in person or virtually, to Muhammad's University of the New Islam's 2021 high school graduation. I would now ask that you please stand for the procession of our graduates. Please remain standing for the singing of our national anthem led by Brother Salim.
Out and free, that we're singing freedom, justice, and equality. Now that we're alone, a hope of our own, we'll know freedom we have ever known. Now we can cheer, our God is here. We have no fear, our God is always here. We'll stand up and fight for what is right. With all our might, come, let us unite. Now that old cross at last we lay down to gain for ourselves. This is solid ground, first and last. First and last, thank you, Allah, we're free at last, free at last, we're free at last.
You may be seated. Days like these are always special when we stop and pause to celebrate the accomplishments of our children. This graduation is a little different in that we cannot all collectively come together to honor our graduate, but I'm sure he knows how happy and proud we are today. But before I go on any further, let me introduce our graduate to everyone. Muhammad's University of the New Islam's 2021 high school graduate, Brother Hamoud Muksin Muhammad. You may be seated, brother. First of all, I want to give our warmest congratulations to our graduate. During this pandemic, we have faced challenges, a few difficulties, and many adjustments were made. But Brother Hamoud adapted, adjusted, and has successfully completed his courses. All praise is due to Allah. When you think about educating children, it's more than just teachers. It's a process that begins at home and continues all the way through school. It cannot be accomplished or measured in one day, one test, or one year. It's a lifelong process that builds on both your successes and your failures. So many people were needed to produce this graduate in front of you. One of them is our next speaker. Sister Danielle Muhammad helped Brother Hamoud throughout his secondary years. She will tell you about her experience.
In the name of Allah, the beneficent, the most merciful, the truthful, the most just, May Allah, assalamu alaikum. As Cynthia mentioned, my name is Sister Danielle, and I'm one of our secondary instructresses here at Muhammad's University of the New Islam. I'd like to welcome everyone here who's viewing over the internet or listening in over our conference line. All praise is due to Allah that we're able to gather here today to celebrate this joyous occasion for Brother Hamoud. As we commemorate this day and of this milestone, Brother Hamoud, we are thankful of the Son of Man and how he has helped us in truly becoming an independent nation, meaning we are free in our actions and our thoughts. We are not under the control or rule of others. We are self-governing. I'm thankful that even though we may use the same books as other schools, our students learn what it is in them so that they're not just to go out and get a job or go out to make a lot of money. They learn so they can bring that knowledge to bring to our nation to make money, not just to make money, but to build our nation. They learn so they cannot take advantage or cheat others, but so they can benefit our nation and others. Always try to put in perspective the growth of our nation as I teach our students. I always want them to know, as Son of Man teaches us, that we don't wait on handouts or wait to be given permission. In America, their schooling system may have started with just a slate, tablet, a chalk, a few books. They may have met just for a few hours a day or a few times a week. But look at where they are today. They have computers, tablets, smart boards, ebooks. They have wireless networking, worldwide online learning and testing systems. Look where we are today. We have those same computers, tablets, smart boards, ebooks, wireless networking. We have nationwide learning and online testing systems as well. So always remember that through Allah's guidance, whatever other nations have, we can have for ourselves. We can do that for ourselves. All praise be to Allah. Now, another thing that I'm thankful for as I reflect over Brother Hamoud's graduation today is that I'm part of the staff of Muhammad's University of the New Islam. With each graduation, it puts me in mind of our previous graduating classes. With each of those classes, whether it be one or three or six graduates, as a teacher, I get to witness them turning the page in a new chapter in their lives as they grow and mature. There are fewer and fewer days of telling them, did you do such and such? You sweep the floor? Why didn't you do such and such? No excuses on why something is not done. Yes. And then just one day you look up and it's done. You don't have to remind them to do anything. So Brother Hamoud, I'm glad to see that you learned to balance some of your silliness. You know there's a time and a place for it. It's good to see that you recognize and welcome your responsibilities. Now when I pass by the auto shop, I don't see you emptying the candy dish, standing around talking. You're suited up in your coveralls, your gloves, your mask, and you're working. So today, Brother Hamoud, I would like to congratulate you on turning that page in that next part of your chapter and the next stage of your growth. With all of the challenges and changes that this year has brought, you've persevered and you've overcome them. I'm very proud of your accomplishments, and you should be proud of those accomplishments too. I pray Allah that you continue to fill your pages with more and more knowledge, reaching that next chapter. I would now like to introduce to you one of our other secondary instructors here at Muhammad's University of the New Islam, who helped to prepare Brother Hamoud for his graduation today, Sister Dara Muhammad. May Allah assalamu alaikum.
In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Most Merciful, the Truthful, and the Most Just, may Allah, Assalamu Alaikum. My name is Sister Dara Muhammad, and I am one of the instructresses here at Muhammad University of the New Islam. For those of you who don't know, I was born and raised in the nation. I went to school at Muhammad University, all the way up from preschool, and I'm now one of the teachers. The Son of Man teaches us that no nation can continue unless they are able to pass on their knowledge from one generation to the next. The graduating class prior to this one also included students I helped teach. One of those graduates was Sister Tayaj. She's now a part of our faculty, and one of her students is my son. So when I think about the fact that these teachers taught me and I taught Sister Tayaj, and now she's back teaching other students, it really amazes me, and it's a blessing that we're able to keep on passing that torch to generation after generation. I'm proud to be a part of that. Some may ask, is our school quote unquote accredited? Wisdom is justified of her children. And as far as I'm concerned, that is the accreditation. When our directress, Sister Cynthia, asked me to help out at the school after I graduated 13 years ago, I gladly accepted. I'm always happy to help our nation out in any way that I can. And what better way than to help do for others what was done for me? And so my journey as a teacher began. This is the third high school class that I've had a hand in, and words cannot really adequately express how I feel in this moment. Being faced with the reality that finally we've come to the end of this road. For this road has been long, it has been difficult, it's been everything but easy. Looking back over all we've been through to get to this moment, I'm just overcome with joy and pride. Thinking back over all the struggles, it makes this victory all the more sweeter. It makes this reward feel even more rewarding. When I was nearing the end of teaching the last high school graduates, Sister Cynthia told me she was going to let me know who I would be teaching next. So when she got back with me, we sat down and she told me she wanted me to teach Brother Hamoud. She mentioned he was the only one in the class, so it would be a one-on-one type of setting, and that was exactly what he needed. I specifically remember her telling me that it was going to be very challenging. It was indeed. When we first started, I felt a little bad for him because he was an only student, and I've experienced what that was like. There's no one else there for the teacher to call on. No one to have any friendly or sometimes not so friendly competition with. No one to talk to when the teacher leaves the classroom. So it can get pretty lonely. As we began our first couple of weeks, I didn't push him right away. I just sort of observed him as a student. He was always very quiet, never too much to say. I tried to ask him questions, make conversation, get him to loosen up a little, but for the most part, it was always the same response to almost every question, just a long and drawn out, So I came to accept that's just the way he was until I stumbled upon him talking to his peers one day. He didn't see me behind him, but it was a whole different Brother Hamoud. He was loud, he was expressive, very passionate about whatever it was they were discussing. So I said to myself, well, he can very well express himself when he wants to. Eventually, he relaxed a little in the classroom, just a little, not much at all. But he was always very respectful. And that was one problem I never had out of him. I know that everyone has different strengths, different limits. But as with all my students, I pushed Brother Hamoud and did not settle for less than I knew he was capable of. I've learned to be able to recognize when the work completed was to the best of the student's ability and when it was not. When an assignment is not up to par because the student didn't really care for the assignment and didn't put their best foot forward, or maybe it wasn't up to par because, well, up to par is relative. As we are taught, learning is a repetitious process. In this case, I have to say the repetition was nonstop. How many times did I have to say, didn't I just tell you last week? Or didn't I just tell you yesterday? But most often, didn't I just tell you 5 minutes ago? So what I'd have to do, you know, sometimes the Son of Man will play an audio or video clip in the meeting, and he'll rewind the same sentence over and over and over and over again. That's what I'd have to do sometimes, say the same thing consecutively over and over and over again to make sure it would stick. Because in addition to learning being a repetitious process, it's also a cumulative process. I try to always impress upon him that you have to remember the lesson we just went over, because the next lesson will only build off of that one. So we had quite a time. And then, as if teaching wasn't already hard enough, here comes the pandemic. As Sister Cynthia said, I think I speak for all of my fellow teachers, that the past year dealing with distance learning, teaching students online only, it made the job at least twofold harder. It was and really still is a massive adjustment. Sister Cynthia said a few adjustments. I think that's an understatement. So it's been a struggle, but you know, I always love a good challenge. Once you finally come out on the other side of it and you've succeeded, that's a feeling like no other. When I say that this journey has been a challenge and that it has not been easy, I'm not talking about just for me. It was challenging for both of us. Brother Hamoud, I know you didn't want to have to sit through all that algebra and chemistry and do all those problems I assigned, especially when it did not come easy for you. But you persevered. You endured, and you should be proud of yourself. This is your accomplishment. We gave you the tools and you did the work. I remember when you asked me at the beginning of last year, you asked if I thought you'd be able to graduate before the year is out. I know it was a great disappointment to you when I told you no, because at the time you simply were not ready. And I had to make sure my job was done completely. So we kept on working at it. And as we were approaching the end of this year, the work we had left, and I told you that if and harder than you ever had before, you could graduate at the end of February. And here we are. Indeed, you worked hard. Together, we put in the extra work, the extra time, night classes, weekend classes. You were faced with difficulty and you prospered. And now I can truly say that my job is done. When you told me your motto was never giving up, I thought that was so fitting. Because even though you did not always succeed the first time, you never did give up. So though it was a challenge to teach you, it was a pleasure. Brother Hamoud has completed the required courses, and this moment is well deserved and fully earned. As you encounter other challenges in life, don't shy away from them because they are hard. Embrace them and know that with the help of Allah, you can do it. The future looks bright for you, so be optimistic. Make smart decisions. And remember, the right way is not always the way that is easy. Never let anyone or anything discourage you. So many past graduates have taken their place and have become an integral part of this nation. I can't wait to see what you do next. Remember, the Son of Man constantly reminds us that anything we want to do of good, he's with us, as long as we are with him. He said that he will never give up on us, as long as we do not give up on him. Just the other night, he said to us, his followers, as far as he was concerned, not even the sky is the limit. So don't be afraid to say what's on your mind. It's okay to offer an opinion and to voice your ideas. So I'm anxious to hear what you have to say. I know everyone is. But we're going to delay that for just about 10 more minutes before we hear from our graduate today. We have a couple of presentations for you to view, courtesy of the class of 2008, Sister Jahara in Detroit and myself. First, Sister Jahara has put together a presentation where we'll take a look at past graduates and see where they are now, the MUONI alumni. Then we will view a slideshow I put together called Through the Years, from babyhood to boyhood to the young man we are honoring here today. After these have concluded, then Brother Hamu will come up and say a few words. May Allah assalamu alaikum.
Thank you. Thank you.
Now our graduate, Brother Hamoud Muksin Muhammad.
In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Most Merciful, the Truthful, and the Most Just. May Allah's Salaam Alaikum. I would like to thank everyone here and everyone on the internet who took their time off and or participate in our 2021 commencement exercises. I want to thank Allah for my mom and dad and Cinnamon, for without them, I wouldn't be here. I also want to thank all the teachers for having the patience to teach me. I'm sure there were some days that required more patience, so I thank you. I thank everyone who had a part in my growth and development. Before I get into some of my experiences with a few of my teachers, I'm going to state something that Sonny Man said once in a meeting. He said that the teachers are kind of like your mothers. And I, for one, have found that to be true. I gave a few examples. Sister Dara was one. Sister Cynthia, she was one too. And Sister Danielle. I want to thank my mom for teaching me in school and in life. She's always helped me when I needed her. And she took care of me when I couldn't take care of myself. And I also want to thank my dad for everything he did for me. He kept a roof over my head, and he also took care of me when I couldn't, and they both continue to do so. Though my dad did not teach me academically, he has and is still sharing his expert knowledge of auto technology with me. More importantly, he is teaching me how to be a man. I want to thank my sisters for helping me with my schoolwork, even though one of them didn't want to be bothered with me. My big little sister, she helped me stay out of trouble. I want to thank one of my teachers, Sister Danielle, for the knowledge that she imparted to me when she was my substitute teacher and as my ACT instructor. I also thank my schoolmates, for even though they were not in the same, we were not in the same grade, I enjoyed being their temporary classmate. They offered me true friendship. I worked with them on a few projects. I was able to portray the drafting of the Constitution and recite the poem If with them at past graduation ceremonies. But the best part was when the other constitutional delegates impeached my cousin Ahijah and made me the president of the Constitutional Convention. I want to thank Sister Dar for teaching me in my last years of high school. She was a kind sister. However, when it came to homework, she was not kind. I would have to go home with a lot of homework. But I know it was needed to prepare me for my graduation. So I thank you. And thank you for the decorations and the cake as well. Finally, I want to thank our leader and teacher, the Son of Man. He has taught us that where there is unity, there is strength. And he passed down to us what the Honorable Elijah Muhammad taught him, the meaning of doing something for self. This school building that I'm standing in now is a result of those teachings. Before I close, I want to share this with my fellow schoolmates, two important life lessons. Never go back on your word, no matter what, and never give up despite what the odds might tell you. So if you're sitting there thinking you can't do this, just remember these words. Hey, Allah, Salaam Alaikum.
For those of you who don't know, my name is Sister Shakira. I'm actually one of the last graduates, a high school graduate from Muhammad's University of the New Islam. And I also happen to be Brother Hamoud's little big sister, as he says. And I just wanted to say that from having been where you were previously, from having been previously where you are now, I understand how proud of yourself that you are, and I'm proud of you too. So this song is dedicated to you. One second.
Okay.
Today has come after a long wait, it's your graduation day. The first thing I'll do is congratulate you on your graduation day. Hard work pays off now, you can help pave the way. Keep your head up high, I know one day you'll be great. Never give up, never give in, keep on striving until you win. And then the sky is the limit, but remember to keep your faith in the Most High, high. And he will take you higher, my friend, is your validation day. And here's my special way to say I'm proud of you on your special day. Just remember to never give up, never give in. Keep on striving until you win and then some. The sky is the limit, but remember to keep your faith in your most high, high, high. And he will take you higher.
Thank you, Sister Shakira. Brother Hamoud has had, Brother Hamoud has also had the pleasure of having his parents as teachers too, as mentioned earlier. Sister Barbara helped lay the foundation for his elementary years. She taught him the majority of his elementary classes. His dad, Brother Robert, who is also the manager of UI Automotives, taught him automotive classes. So collectively, we produced this graduate. All praise is due to Allah. I myself haven't had the experience of teaching Brother Hamoud, only a substitution here and there, but we often passed each other in this hallway. His pleasant personality always brought a smile to my face, even after I fussed at him. I watched him grow, learn, and mature into a respectful young man. Now, our leader and teacher and the superintendent of Muhammad's University of the New Islam, the Son of Man, will speak.
In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Most Merciful, the Truthful, and the Most Just. May Allah's Salaam Alaikum. I want to say about our graduate here. To see this young man grow from a baby to a toddler to a adolescent to where he is now. I have seen this over and over, as that slideshow showed you. And I'm so proud of what you all have accomplished based on what I was taught that I shared with you. It makes you get full. I don't often find myself at a loss for words, but sometimes words are inadequate. I know sometime I'll be sitting at home, and the phone rang, and Brother Hamoud on the phone. And I said, what's going on? He said, well, I just called to see how you doing. And that really meant a lot to me. It means a lot to me to know that people that I care about care back. They care about me too. But it makes all of the hateful things that I experienced for the past 40-some years, it just melts it all away. And I gotta tell you how much that meant to me and means to me. Because I mean, I get calls from him from time to time. And I remember his daddy was fussing at him because he was working on the car and forgot to tighten the oil. The man, the motor blew up. And his daddy was really upset. And me and him had a good laugh about it. Because I said, didn't you tell me that you did something similar that your daddy got on? And he started laughing, saying, yeah. He said, well, he walked up and down one side. I said, well, that's what you're supposed to do. Do what your daddy did. Do that to him. So then it will remain. And that lesson is a growing thing. And then we just got together and replaced what it was he messed up. It's one thing to say you got their back. Well, they find out whether you got their back or not when they mess up something and you get their back. Huh? So this is what we have to do. We have to stick by one another, you know, through whatever. Is it like where we say the sky? Most people don't even understand what sky is the limit is. Well, the sky is the limit that you can go. You climb Mount Everest or whatever, you get up so high, you almost running out of sky. The sky that you can live in. Do you understand? But they figured out a way that make the sky not the limit. Take some of it out there with you. Is that right? Then the sky becomes the means to the unlimited. Do you understand? So your brain does not have a empty and full meter on it. It comes like the universe. Is that all there is? Well, let's keep going and see. So just keep going. Don't limit yourself, because Allah has not limited any of us. We put those limits on ourselves by being other than what we were designed for. We were designed to be the seat of truth, the temple of truth. Then we are supposed to always be ready to receive more of what the truth that we have guides us to about other things. And if we ever get satisfied and say, I don't have enough truth, that's like saying, I don't have enough of God. And when you decide that you don't have enough of him, he don't have enough of you. So let's rejoice in the fact that we are able to produce knowledge in ourselves, from among ourselves, to enable us to take care of ourselves. That's called independence. So I'm proud of you, man. I am very proud of you. And I'm proud of you, you teachers who taught your siblings, your cousins, your broader family. Brings to mind what that, I think they call it an African proverb. Takes a village to raise a child. So we know that's true in our little village here. Collectively, we had all we needed to raise our children. Huh? And we naturally the book says the bridegroom is the one with the bride. The bride is a virgin. You and many of you sitting on the back there, y'all was all virgins. Y'all was babies. And we educated you. The bridegroom is the one with the bride. Huh? Now, the wedding, something old, as you pointed out. We use some of the books that they wrote, as you pointed out. But the knowledge that we got out of those books, Allah enabled us to make it new, to understand it in a way that is not taught anywhere but with us. Do you understand? You notice you've been speaking English all your life, but I've been teaching you a new English. It's the same words, but they have more meaning now, don't they? Well, all praise is due to Allah. So, we are not going to burn down this world. We are going to give it a rebirth if they let us. All right? We have already begun the process. And so to our graduate again, congratulations, young man.
Thank you.
And keep on going. And we got you back. May Allah's salam alaikum.
And I'll give you back to our directors here.
Muhammad University of the New Islam's High School Diploma. This certifies that Hamoud Muskin Muhammad has successfully completed the required coursework assigned by Muhammad University of the New Islam for grades 1 through 12 to receive this diploma. Given as evidence of scholastic achievement, this diploma is awarded and herewith confers a graduate of Muhammad University of the New Islam. Given this 27th day of February 2021. And this certificate of achievement is presented to Brother Hamoud for exemplary performance and achievement in the subject area of English. Secondary Division awarded this 27th day of February 2021. As I said earlier, Brother Hamoud has been taking automotive classes with his dad, Brother Robert. He would like to present him a certificate for his efforts.
May Allah salam alaikum.
What is this, Sister C? Why are you doing this to me? You couldn't think this.
I don't do this very well, but since it's Hamoud, Hamoud is my first son to graduate from Muhammad University of New Islam. And I didn't think Hamoud was gonna have many midichlorians. And as it turns out, Hamoud has zero midichlorians. but he does have a couple of auto midichlorians. So we're going to work with that. He's been progressing well. He takes to what we give him, and he's making progress. So hopefully one day you can come up there and not have to worry about asking for Brother Robert. You could come up there and ask for Brother Hamoud. And that would be a great day.
Yes.
Muhammad's University of the New Islam Certificate of Apprenticeship is awarded to Hamoud Muksin Muhammad, having met all necessary requirements and hereby certified as completing UI Automotive's Apprentice Program in Automotive Repair, to which we, the undersigned, attest to this the 27th day of February, 2021. Again,
again, well done, Brother Hamoud. Always remember to be thankful for what Allah has blessed you with. Treat every day as a lesson learned, and may Allah bless you with success. I would like to thank everyone again for joining us to celebrate what we have collectively accomplished. As always, I thank everyone who made this graduation a success. Sister Lois for our beautiful decorations, Brother Michael X for our live streaming and tech support, and Brother Jamar, and Brother Calvin for our music, Brother Michael 1X for our diploma and certificates. And one of the things we strive to do as we get older is to pass on our knowledge and skills to our children. Sister Doris oversaw all of the arrangements for this graduation. She only consulted me from time to time. I think she did an excellent job. Let's give her a hand. And to my fellow beloved teachers who couldn't be here with us today, I know you feel the same joy as I do for helping to produce another graduate of Muhammad's University of the New Islam. Thank you for your continued hard work. Please stand for the recession of our graduate.
If you call out loud, we get inside. The heart we will surrender to your advice, and you can say the words like a wondrous game. The power of believing to give yourself a chance, 'cause you can climb a high mountain.
I'm I'm